Let's take a look now at the drainage library, and we'll review the pieces of that library. Like I said before, the drainage library can be used for numerous projects. So you would have one drainage library, and that drainage library would contain all the necessary rainfall data, pipes and sizes and types, nodes, land use information to serve any project in your area. So starting on page 1-9, we're going to open up our drainage library and kind of review the tabs, the rainfall, land use, nodes, links, and spread section tab. So under drainage, project, right below preferences, we have drainage library. That'll open up the drainage library that we're using for this particular project that we're in called site plan. You can see it's broken up into tabs. We have a rainfall tab, a land use tab, nodes, links, and spread section. Back at the rainfall tab, let's just take zone 1 for example and double click on it. You can see here the rainfall data for zone 1 has been entered as an equation, and the user has populated the coefficients to be used depending on the frequency chosen. Other information that's supported would be a table. Again, the frequencies inputted in the duration table. These tables can be populated with an ASCII file or through Hydro 35 or TP40. Also, take a look real quick here at the hydrograph, and you can see again input the cumulative rainfall frequencies and the duration and its corresponding values. Next up is the land use tab, and this is where again we mentioned the shapes earlier. For example, grass. I have grass set at 0.5, and it exists on a certain level, color, weight, and style. And I've done that same set of items for each type of land use that I may encounter. Pavement, buildings, and so forth. And their corresponding land use values. So therefore, when we're in the file, again, if we have a drainage area that falls within a land use shape, the portion of that shape will be looked at and assigned a particular C value from the drainage library land use value or land use table. The nodes tab will display each type of node that we can use on any particular project, and you can see the node types that we support. We have a curb, grate, slotted drain, curb and grate, junction, outlet, other, bottom, and head wall. So depending on which type of node type that I'm placing, the list will show you what's available in your library. So if I take a look at, for example, the curb inlet, and just double click on one, you can see the item ID, a description, and a link to a pay item or DNC manager DDB item, a cell, link to a cell in a cell library, and the type and the available profile that it could be placed on. So in this case, this particular inlet is available for placement in either a sag condition or on grate. And at time of placement, that's how I choose the type. The hydraulic characteristics of that inlet, length, width, depth, curb opening, all the necessary information to help us calculate spread and capacity. I switch to a grate, same information basically, the ID and description shown in the library, the cell, the profile type, and then data for on grade and data for SAG. And here you can see we have reduction factors to take into account, clogging of a grate and so forth. We move on down to junctions. Junctions, there's no hydraulic calculations performed on a junction or a manhole, so therefore that part of the dialog is missing. But it does link us to a cell and, of course, a pay item for quantity purposes. And that would be true with junction, outlet, other, bottom, and headwall. No hydraulics performed on those. Take a look at the link tab. Standard in our default library and in this library are over 1500 pipes already inputted. And you would just choose the particular shape and material. And then you could take a look at any particular pipe there. So all pipes would have the ID and description entered. You would have to link it to a pay item if you want to calculate quantities. And its corresponding roughness and thickness and rise are inputted, along with trench details, so if we want excavation quantities for laying that pipe. Next up is spread section, and these would be used to fill in the, when I'm creating a node, one of the sections I have to input is the typical spread section for that node, and if I'm laying nodes, for example, along a roadway, that section may never change, so that I can quickly access a section of the library and saves me time when creating the dialog. So that concludes the drainage library. I'm going to go ahead and close that and not save any changes. And next up, we're going to start with laying out our drainage system.